Hey, what's up guys, welcome back, you're watching for today. So it's been long time we didn't review the legendary custom ROM Evolution X, but as I switched to the retrofit partition on the rising OS, I decided to review the latest AOSP build of Evolution X 8.6, which comes with the lots of amazing features and add-ons that needs to be reviewed. So today in this video we will find out why this ROM now ranks first in my list of favorite custom ROMs for the OnePlus 6 and 6T. Now without further delay, let's get started. As this is a retrofit ROM, your device must be on the retrofit dynamic partition system. Video tutorial link is available under the video description for how to convert your device partition into the dynamic system. Next, flash the ROM via Evolution X recovery and then format data and reboot your device. I already did hold the steps and my device is running on this stunning looking new Evolution X. If you check the about device details now, this is the Android 14 latest QPR 2 source based ROM. Setting as the new Evolution X detail section, where you guess all the details of Evolution X ROM. Like this is the AOSP based Evolution X 8.6 version. Version codename is Isaw with the Evolution X exclusive history. Build maintainer is Veritas. Build date of this ROM is latest 19th May 2024. Security patch of this build is latest of May 2024. ROM comes with the latest version of kernel 4.9.37 build date with the latest client toolchain 17. It supports the kernel. So this is a new source based and highly optimized build of Evolution X. Now let's check out some add-ons added by the developers as per the changelog. First one is the developers added the new Google's original core recording application, which has this nice looking user interface. Next, developer added back the Adreno GPU touch boost under the OnePlus setting, and the Adreno GPU thermal throttling toggle is also available if the GPU touch boost causing the device heating. This is typically useful for the better gaming experience on this aged device. We will soon test the BGMI on this device using this feature in another video. As you already told in the device details timeline of this video, ROM now comes with the kernel supporting kernel inbuilt. You can install the kernel application using the link given under the video description and can use the root features without breaking the safety net of your device using the new kernel. Even if you have the kernel super user access, safety net getting passed and device play protect integrity is certified, this one is a great achievement. ROM comes with the Google Gemini inbuilt, but to use this we need to first update our Google application. Once done, set up the Google Assistant, open Gemini application, set up it now. Now you have the Google Gemini instead of Google Assistant on your device. You can use it to complete your various tasks like ChatGPT. ROM comes with the new link to Windows application in the app drawer, so we can connect our device to the Windows PC using this application by just scanning the QR code on your PC. I did not try this to connect my PC, but it should work as this is a system-based application. ROM comes with the fully working Android 14 AI wallpapers and the emojis wallpaper, which are looking very nice on OnePlus 6. You can check them here. Some new lock screen clocks were added by the team under the wallpapers and style application, which has this nice animation and they are working even on the always on display. ROM comes with the fully working OnePlus camera with the latest version 3.2. Everything works in this camera, but it has only one bug that we will show you under the bug section of this video. Here are some samples of the panorama mode, 4K 60fps video recording and the slow motion. We'll be right back. ROM comes inbuilt with the new Dolby Atmos sound mode under the sound and the vibration setting. It has lots of equalizer presets, Dolby sound profiles, dialogue announcer, volume leveler toggle, and I can truly say it really improves the sound quality of the device to the next level. Under the quick setting customizations of the Evolver tab, developer added the new setting to convert the QS panel tiles into the rounded or the square shapes. We can use both of them, like round shape for the activated tiles and the square shape for non-activated tiles. Under the lock screen setting, developers added some new lock screen animated clocks, but here there is one serious bug you may face that I will discuss in the bug section of this video. But these styles of the clocks looks amazing on the lock screen and on the always on display. iPhone style depth wallpaper setting is available here, but it's not working. Under the miscellaneous setting, we get the different spoofing options for the plane ticket fix, unlimited photo backup, unlock RFS in the games, Netflix and the Snapchat spoofing for solving the issue of Snapchat which is not working on the Android 14 builds. Smart pixel is another feature to shut off some pixels of the display to save more battery under the emergency condition, and it's working good with this build. In the previous build, it's not working at all. Under the battery stat, developers added some unique and more useful features like charging control to limit the charging of the device, sleep mode setting to turn off some functions like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, network, etc. during specified time, which helps to prolong your device battery. Battery diagnostics offers some battery saving tips by the Google to solve battery draining quickly, phone got warmer, and issues for the charging of the device. Battery information option gives all the details of your device battery, so you can confirm device battery is healthy or not. So we've seen all the new amazing features of new Evolution X, but there are some issues or the bugs. First one is for the camera. Camera is fully working. Only selfie camera portrait pictures are not working. It's causing camera unusable. We need to foreclose the camera application and restart it to make it work again. Another major issue I already mentioned is regarding the lock screen clock. If you are using the lock screen clock offered by the Evolver customization, then if you try to apply another lock screen clock styles using the wallpaper and style setting, it's causing the hanging of the device and it can't be usable anymore later. Only wallpaper screen you will see on the device, and you can't able to solve this issue by just rebooting the device. The only solution is format data of the device using the stock recovery. So my recommendation is that if you want to apply the lock screen clock, only use one customization setting offered by the Evolver tab or through the wallpaper style setting. Except this, nothing is serious about this build. It's really smooth, highly customizable, and highly battery efficient custom ROM for OnePlus 6 and 60. That's why it's my number one contender in the list of custom ROM for the OnePlus 6 and 60 now. That's it for today guys. Hope you liked my work. Then please do like and share this video, subscribe our channel, press the bell icon for the notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.